As women get older and start to see the signs of aging, it's important to switch up your makeup routine to enhance your features. Sometimes less is more, so I'm going to show you how to get a vibrant, fresh face look and really bring out a youthful glow. As skin matures, it becomes increasingly more important to use a primer. It fills in fine lines, minimizes pores, and creates a canvas so that you can actually use less foundation. With a brush or a sponge, apply it all over the face. When choosing a foundation, it's important to look for one that boosts hydration or offers anti-aging and skin-firming properties. Today, I'm going to be using CoverGirl and Olay Tone Rehab Foundation. Also very important is to look for one that has a warm, yellowish tone to it. That helps cancel out redness in the skin, so try and stay away from foundations that have pinkish tones. Paying extra attention to your brows can really frame the face and give the overall illusion of a lift. So to choose the right color, go one shade lighter than your hair color, or in Sharon's case, since she's a beautiful platinum blonde, we're gonna use the fairest blonde color pencil that they have. And I'm just going to take light, feathery strokes along the brow to fill in some of the areas where it's sparse. Now it's time for concealer. As skin matures and it gets thinner around the eyes and more fine lines, it's important to use a more emollient product that's not going to settle into those lines. It's going to deflect light and create the appearance of a more youthful glow. The gold standard is YSL Touche Éclat. They come in many different colors now, and they have light reflecting properties that really make your eyes look brighter and appear fresher and more awake. Next, onto eyeshadow. Look for colors in the neutral family, such as champagne, soft browns and bronzes, and also pewters. Today I'm gonna be using Maybelline's Color Tattoo in Bad to Bronze, and I'm with a soft domed brush. I'm gonna apply it all over Sharon's lid. It's better to stay away from eyeshadows with too much shimmer in them. A tiny bit of light diffusing particles can really be beautiful and open up the eye, but when you get into too much glitter, it can be too harsh and look severe. After cream eyeshadow, we're gonna talk about eyeliner. Ladies, fall in love with your brown eyeliner again. Sometimes black can come off just looking too harsh and severe. Brown can really be soft and beautiful, especially for Sharon's beautiful blue eyes. Brown is gonna make them pop and look even more blue. I'm gonna line the top of the eye, and either with your finger or a brush, I'm gonna smudge it into the lash line just to add a soft definition. I'm also using a waterproof formula that's soft and easy to smudge, but won't go anywhere once it sets. To finish off the eye, we're gonna curl the lashes and use a waterproof mascara formula. Now, we are talking about a youthful glow here, so blush is really important. Stay away from neutrals and look for bright pinks or peaches. Today, I'm using Maybelline's Dream Bouncy Blush with a big fluffy brush to apply on the apples of the cheeks and going upwards. So now I'm gonna use a little bit of translucent setting powder to set the makeup and to take away shine just in the T-zone area. After powder, I'm using a bronzer to warm up the complexion and add dimension to the face. I'm just taking a fluffy brush and rubbing it into the hairline, along the cheekbone, and onto the jawline. To finish off the look, we're gonna talk about lips. The natural pigment in your lip can tend to fade, so choosing a color that's the same shade as your lip or a few shades darker is all you need. And with that, we are finished. Beautiful. So that completes Sharon's fresh face look. Like I said before, less is more. Thanks so much for watching.